Hello friends, our today's topic is trigonometry. In this video, we will learn why the values of cos 30 degree is root 3 by 2 and that of the value of cos 60 degree is 1 by 2. First of all, for proving these values, we need an equilateral triangle here. So we are drawing an equilateral triangle here like this, whose sides are 8 unit and also 8 unit. Now we know that trigonometry is associated with the right angle triangle, and in this figure we don't have any kind of right angle triangle. So for having the right angle triangle, we are drawing a perpendicular from the vertex A to the base BC, which is cutting the BC at the point D. That means this angle is becoming 90 degrees. Now all of us know that the angle of an equilateral triangle are 60 and that of 60 degree. If in this right angle triangle we are drawing this one here A, B and D, this is becoming 60 and this angle is here 90 degree. Obviously this part is going there, so obviously this angle would be 30 degree. Now we know this part is A unit and this is the perpendicular on the base BC, and for the equilateral triangle this bisects the base BC. That means this would be A by 2. Now by using the Pythagoras theorem, we can easily find out the value of AD. We are finding here by Pythagoras theorem, we are having AD square plus BD square equals to AD square. Clear? So we are just putting the values of here. AD square, we don't know the value of AD, so this is becoming like this. Now the value of BD is A by 2 whole square, and that of the value of AB is A square. Now AB square is becoming A square minus A by 2 whole square. Now we need another space, so we are using this part. So this is becoming AB square equals to A square minus A square by 4. We are doing the LCM here, 4 A square minus A square. This is giving you 3 A square by 4, and this is AB square. So for having the value of AD, it would be root 3 A square by 4. That means it will be root 3 A by 2. Clear? So it will be this unit. Now we all know the value of AD, AB and BD. Now we need the value of cos of 30 degree. Therefore, cos 30 degree. We know cos theta equals to base by hypotenuse. Here, so in case of cos 30 degree, this is becoming the base, AD is becoming base, and AD is becoming the hypotenuse. So it would be AD by AB. Therefore, we are having cos 30 equals to AD. We know the value of AD, that is root 3 A by 2, and also we know the value of AB, that is A. Here, now we can easily cancel out the A and A. because the value of A cannot be 0. If the value becomes 0, we cannot cancel this, because 0 by 0 is undefined, we all know. But any length of a side, it cannot be 0 for a triangle, so this we can cancel it out. Therefore, we can easily find out cos 30 equals to root 3 by 2. Clear? Now we need to find out the value of cos 60 degree. What would be the value of cos of 60 degree? Cos 60 degree. For cos 60 degree, this would be base. Clear? This would be base and this would be the hypotenuse. BD would be the base for cos 60 degree. With respect to the angle 60 degree, BD would be the base and AB would be the hypotenuse. That means cos theta equals to base by hypotenuse. We know the value of BD. This is A by 2. And we know the value of AB also, which is becoming A. So we are having A by 2 into 1 by A. Because it was divided here. If we multiply this sign, so it would be reciprocalized. The reciprocal of A would be 1 by A. Now again, by the same reason, you can cancel this A, because the value of A cannot be 0. So it is becoming 1 by 2. And thus it is true. The value of cos 30 degree, you can see here, it is come, it has come then root 3 by 2, and that of the cos 60 degree has come here 1 by 2.